All right, welcome, welcome. We're gonna play some Angelic Renewal. Keep this, that's fine. He's probably playing Burn. Play this. Oh, so he's not playing Burn. Okay. Play this. Play one Squadron Hawk. Grab a Squadron Hawk. Pass turn. Press record, right? Playing most likely Monarch. Basic land cycling. Get ourselves island. Play the island. Play a Squadron Hawk. Yes, you get another Squadron Hawk. No reason to attack. All right. So play a Squadron Hawk. And turn a land. Next turn we can start playing Mold Drifters. So we'll probably play Angelic. Try to get some of this stuff out of our hands so we don't have to discard a hand size. Yeah, let's triple block this guy. He wants to use two burns to yeah, that's fine. We're just gonna play Molder. Play land. Angelic Duel, Ethereal Armor, another Angelic Duel, last turn, even if he uses a burn to kill this guy, turn it with our Auromancer. Wait till we okay. So first things first, we will invoke a monster. Sacrifice one of these to return it. We'll play Squadron Hawk. I was expecting to draw land, but that obviously did not happen. Yeah, not drawing a land there was kind of annoying. Take four. Kinda sucks, but whatever. Basic land cycling. Plains. To the plains. Use Oromancer back, Aether Armor. Use Aether Armor on Squadron Hawk in case he has a burn. All right, and pass turn. We're getting not being able to cast all the spells we want to cast, and that's kind of sad. So, hopefully he doesn't burn us out now. That would suck. Yes, usability. All right, that's pretty good. All right. Play this land. We'll play this next turn. I'm going to believe I have something that gains 4 life when it enters the battlefield. Also, like a Arrest. Yeah, there you go. Faithless Fetters. Enchant one of these guys. Then, yeah, that puts us in a little bit better position. Don't swing. Now we have blockers. Kind of worried, though, about eventually at some point he's going to be able to burn us out. Turning nowhere. That's not good. Yeah, well, we'll be able to cast some flyers next. Yeah, definitely need flyers. Okay. And this one. Old Drifter cast. All right. Pass turn. We're super close to dead though. Yep, he might just have the burnout already. Yeah, we can't do anything about that. Okay. So. Your bear is probably pretty good. Seal of cleansing is probably is a possibility. Prismatic shrink. Did so many chances to gain life. Let's not worry about the standard bear. Prismatic strands. We definitely want these though. They interact with a lot of his board. Squadron Hawks are probably just bad. Take out all four of those. Bring in one shrink. That way. Yes, I would like to play first. Sure, I'll keep. Yield until the next sentence. We'll go get an island. We have a lot of pretty. Go get planes. Play this. Turn to planes. All right. Seal of cleansing. We'll use this to destroy their land. Play a land. Angelic Renewal. Last turn. Take two. We'll go Oblivion Ring, targeting Glinthawk. Go Core Skyfisher, targeting Oblivion Ring. And then pass turn. Yes, we will. We'll just return an island. I don't need to know where. Okay. Play land. Play the Mole Drifter. Nice. Play Angelic Renewal. That's fine. Play Mortuary Mire. Not on top. Living Ring, the Journey of Nowhere. We'll return Mortuary Mire to our hand. That is fine. Play Mole Drifter. Play a Bounce Land. Last turn. We'll take 4, that's fine. Play land. Play crystallization on one of these. Play Pilgrim. Yes. And we'll add another one. And pass turn. Okay. That's fine. Oh, that's exactly the kind of stuff we need. In some life. Play land. Living Ring, the other Skyfisher, and pass turn. Or actually, we'll swing for two. Totally forgot that they can still block. Alright. This is going to be a really grindy matchup. Okay. Cool. Field cleansing. We got the land again. Pass turn. That's fine. Tap, 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 draw two. Go fetch an island. Play the island. Start swinging. Okay. Cycle. We'll get ourselves a planes. Play the planes. Swing for six. And play Oblivion Ring. Targeting one of the glint. Okay, we will go block or no block, 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 take seven. Does he have enough burn to burn us out again? Well, that sucks. Alright, well, let's go get some life gain. Yes. Gift of Orzhov. Back for three. Gain three. Mortuary Mire. Bring him back. Put Missionary on top of the deck. Yes, usability. All right. We will swing with a Mull Drifter. If you would like to trade, we'll use Angelic Renewal to bring it back and draw two cards. many tokens. Made of conscience, I guess. Swing for two. Sure. That's fine. Ether armor on this guy. We'll just go gain a bunch of life. Hope he doesn't have a fog. He does not. Okay, cool. Well, that puts us in a pretty good position. Wait, is that a target? It's not target. Okay. Swing for nine. Lake Horse Skyfisher. Turn Mole Drifter. Play the Mole Drifter. He's gonna counter it. Okay. That sucks. That is what it is, you know? All right, well, that breaks the evenness. But he's got to start trying to win. Well, in response, spectrum from white. but you're not gonna deal any damage. Okay. We'll go. Sure. That's fine. Okay. Turn the Mole Drifter again. Attempt to cast the Mole Drifter again after Helion's Pilgrim. Ability. We'll go get Faith's Fetters. Cast Mole Drifter again. Sure. Swing him for two. Nice. Okay, get rid of Mole Drifter. That's fine. Sure. All right, play this first. And pass turn. Okay. All righty. Okay. I think he just messed up. Unless he's got fog. Does. Well, that's game. Alright. Yeah, he's got plenty enough attackers. Okay, well, that was a long match, but we just kind of get done. But felt like it was close. And that's one of the top tier 1 decks anyways, so I don't feel too bad about it. I'll see you guys in the next match. Yes, I'd like to play first. Sure, we'll keep this. Gain some life. Alright, well, we're definitely weight of consciencing that guy. All right. Go land. Pass with evoke Mole Drifter. All right, Oblivion Ring's good. And Lone Missionary is really good, so. Alright. Ooh, that's perfect, actually. What we'll do is go Lone Missionary. Gain 4 life. We'll play Angelic Renewal. Okay. So, yeah. No, I'm cool with that, actually. That the Angelic Renewal just gained us 4 life. I'm cool with that. Cool. And then, well, you're going to use Mortuary. We're going to play Squadron Hawk into Mortuary Mire into Missionaries next turn. That sucks that we drew the one of the Squadron Hawks because we were going to play it finally, but we could have played it earlier and not had that happen, so. Yes, usability. Grab 2 more. Mortuary Mire. Put the Lone Missionary on top. Yes. Play another Squadron Hawk. Then are done for this turn. Lone Missionary, Chancellor, return Mortuary Mire. We will Living Ring this guy. Swing for 2. Mortuary Mire on there. Usability. We're gonna exile this with this guy. Swing for two with this lone missionary. Ormancer. Bring that back. Yes. Legend Hawk. No. Pass turn. Back. Legend Hawk. Nope. And pass turn. Oh, he has to kill me this turn. Which is possible. He went like land, 2-1 mana burn spells, and another fire blast. That definitely would kill us. All right. Cool. So we are going to bring in Prismatic Strand spells. I want to bring in Standard Barrier too. Nah, we don't really. Okay, what do we take out? Ethereal Armor might just be not necessary, or do we take out Squadron Hawks? I feel like we take out Squadron Hawks. Yeah. One Oromancer. Yeah, let's run like that. We'll keep. He mulligans to 6. Rise to the top. Lava Spike. Okay. Chain Lightning. Okay. Alrighty. Gain 4. Are we likely to die this turn? Don't think so. I'd rather be more efficient with my mana. We're gonna evoke this. We'll use Mortuary Mire, the Mole Drifter on top. Hope we're not dead. Okay, that's not terrible. I mean, it's not preferable, but we actually are in a pretty good spot because of it. Clone Missionary. And Weight of Conscience. Then we can exile it right away. Yep. Now he has two cards to try to deal 14 damage. That puts us in a pretty good spot. Yep, that does suck. Yep. But Prismatic Shrine. Try to more lands. Turn Mortuary Mire. We'll go Angelic Renewal. Mortuary Mire. Targeting on Missionary. We'll keep up Prismatic Strands. Okay. We'll go tap, tap, Clone Missionary, gain some life, and pass turn. Well, we have the answer to that right now, so that's good. So, Monk Idealist. Weight of Conscience. And they're both monks. Well, luckily we have another Weight of Conscience right now in our hand. Pass turn. Swing for four. Monk idealist. Get one of the weight back. Spent all red spells this turn. And he scoops. Okay. Cool. Well, obviously, Burn's a good matchup, and I'll see you guys next match. Alright, let's play first. We will keep. Until the next. Yield until the next step. Okay. So we'll go get blue. Island. Squadron Hawk. This is probably mono green land destruction. Because he picked green. So we're just trying to get threats out so we can start attacking. Okay, so I was wrong. Okay, cool, cool. We will go another Squadron Hawk. No, because we're going to return a land and we'll have to discard. Playland. Play Angelic Renewal. Play Squadron Hawk. Nope. Swing for two. Don't think we can win game one, but post game one, game two and three should be in our favor. For the fact that. Oh shit, that's hella game. Okay. Let's see here. So we definitely want. So we have standard barriers, good. Seal of Cleansing is good. Magic Strands is good. Holy Light is actually good too. Rite of Conscience doesn't really do anything. I gotta still get rid of seven Faith Fetters, doesn't do anything. We're not gonna win that battle. And gaining life doesn't seem great. Seems okay, but I think having access to like removal and stuff better. Yeah, we'll play first. Not the right land. Okay, so this is definitely keepable. We'll put that on top. Gives us access to play all our spells. Heal of cleansing. Okay. Rancor's fine. Get rid of the armor. Leyland. Keep up Holy Light. Take three. Okay. Fender Bear. Then we'll play Angelic Renewal. Play a Plains. Swing for one. Angelic Renewal rather than the Mold Drifter, just in case he does get his gut shot or anything. Basic Cycling. Logan Island. Cast Mold Drifter. Okay. We're in a commanding lead now. We're in a commanding place at least. Swing for two first. Squadron Hawk. Yes. And then we'll keep up Prismatic Strands to protect Standard Bearer. Go Squadron Hawk. No Squadron Hawk. No. Totally messed that up. I should have tapped different mana so I could have still had Prismatic Strands. Hopefully it ends up not being a big deal. Hopefully, but no guarantees. Alright, he scoops. Getting sideboarding. I only think I have one thing that's fetchable, right? Yeah, I took out the pilgrims for a reason. Okay, cool. Because I only have one thing that's fetchable, so good. Alright, I was just making sure about that. Yeah. Okay. Pretty solid. Yeah, I like it. I'll keep. Well, so we have some enchantment removal. Hopefully he doesn't have a removal for my standard barrier, but if he does, at least we have Oblivion Rings. Take one, that's fine. The fight enchantment is probably okay. Well, that kind of actually is, it works too. All right, play this. Turn the planes. Pass turn. Okay, play this, gain a life, have both of these, Oblivion Ring, the cartouche, and pass turn. Next turn we can play Mole Drifter and be in a pretty decent spot. Well, that sucks. All right, we'll go tap tap, Living Ring. Targeting Ring Core. Then Seal of Cleansing. The next turn we can use Oromancer with Seal of Cleansing. We'll stop the bleeding a little bit. Okay. All right. Take five. Doesn't feel great, but okay. Kill one of the Utopia Sprawls. And we'll go Oromancer. Turning the seal. Yes. Play the seal. A chancellor. Turn the planes. And I think we're dead. That sucks. We're so close. That sucks. Alright, see you guys in the next match. Alright, let's try to play a little bit better. I probably punted game three of last game for the fact that, or the last match for the fact that I didn't protect my standard bearer early. Let's try not to punt this game. Should be 2-1, not one land both times, so we're probably going down to 5. Alright, this is much better. We'll keep bottom that. Okay. Basic land cycling. Let's go get ourselves an island. Play the Mortuary Mire. So we can either play Oblivion Ring or evoke the Moldrifter next turn. Maybe we should keep that land on top. Okay, could either be Blue-Black Delver, it could be Tyless Tribe, we're not really sure quite yet. We will go Cycle, get ourselves a Plains. We will go Squadron Hawk. Dazing. That sucks. We had the land. That's garbage. I think it's more or less likely blue black, yeah, over then. This weight of conscience is be pretty good against Gurmagging. So are these guardians not quite as good? We'll attempt to cast one anyway. That's fine. Augur Bulls. That's fine. Not super worried about that. Well, hopefully he finds a Gurmag Angler and casts it this turn. Because if he does that, then we'll very easily wave conscience it. Good. Solid. Sounds good. Well, we will play a land. Conscience this guy. Pass turn. Take one, that's okay. Yeah, let's go for the Guardian. Gush and then trying to foil. Okay. That feels real good, actually, for us. Delver Secrets. Okay. We get untapped land, we'll go Moldrifter because he can't daze then. If we don't get untapped land, we're going Oblivion Ring. In Road of Delver Secret. Untap land. Let's go get our Moldrifter on. Okay. Don't want to get probe. Okay. That's fine with me. He has removal for the Moldrifter. That's like his best situation. But without removal for the Moldrifter, I'm just going to trade him off. And anyways, this turn I have Oblivion Ring and another Way of Conscience. Okay. Fully trading, he did not attack. Okay. Alright, first things first, let's attempt to Weight of Conscience this guy. Then we are going to Squadron Hawk. Yes, usability. Grab the other two. And then swing for two. Now we have Edict Fodder. We have their two biggest threats nullified. Pretty soon, after we cast this next Squadron Hawk, we can start bringing back Weight of Conscience. Top with Preordain. Okay. Well, we're going to attempt to bring out the Squadron Hawks. Oop. Exile this guy. Back for four. Echoing to decay that guy, that's fine. Take two. Then we will go and use Monk Idealist to return the Weight of Conscience. Yep. And we will pass turn. All right, Gush. Echoing Decay, that's fine, sure. Get Probe, sure. Having them on a 5-turn clock is pretty good, actually. They're just trying to grind their way out. Ooh. Fulgrim. Okay. Yes, usability. What else do we have? We'll bring out the gift, then we'll play Squadron Hawk. We'll swing for two. No. Back for two. Okay, that's fine. Preordain. Sure. Preordain. So we'll go tap, tap, tap. Gift of Orzhov. Pay for days. Oil. So he just traded 1, 2, 3, 4 cards for one enchantment that I don't particularly care about. Sounds like a amazing trade to me. That's fine. All right. Do weight of conscience on this guy. Do crystallization on this guy. We'll do Mortuary Mire, targeting Mole Drifter. And we'll swing for 3. And pass turn. All right. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. We bring in, though. Spells. This. I think one Seal of Cleansing for their graveyard hate that they're going to bring in. They have one Angelic Renewal. One Oromancer. We shave one Squadron Hawk. And I don't really like Ethereal Armor. I mean, it's good. But a one of, just for the, like, trying to finish. Mostly we're trying to play the control game. Oh, Missionary, that good? Yeah, in case they get that Delver. Yeah, this seems fine. And I'm cool with that. He probably has no clue what to bring in. That's part of the benefit of, like, playing a deck like this, is you get to have the benefit of other players, like, trying to figure you out, you know? Okay. We're also ahead in time, which is pretty awesome. All right. Okay, well, we have interaction draw as well as we can go fetch something. More interaction, basically. I might keep this, that's fine. We still don't want to see a turn one Delver. That's probably the worst thing for us, but. Yep. Weight of Conscience? Oh, that's pretty good, actually. All right, is he gonna blind flip? Yep, he did. Ball kidding. All right, well, luckily. Ooh. Nah, wait a turn. Lone missionary. Gain four life. Last turn. He swings for three. He passed turn to us. That dispel is actually pretty good. Weight of Conscience. That's fine. That's the trade. I'm completely and utterly okay with that. Cool. Yeah, we'll dispel that. Yeah, he wants to use days, he can. We'll go tapped. Tab. Liliana's Pilgrim. Yes. Go get another Weight of Conscience. Play Chancery. Bring back Plains. Preordain. Goes bottom. Okay. Diabolic Edict us. Mag Angler. Okay. Cool with that. Cool. We will go land. Oblivion Ring. Jermag Angler. And play a relic. He did not play the land, so we know that he has at least one island and one Diabolic Edict. Get probe, sure. That's fine. Plays one of the islands. Plays an island. Don't know for sure he has an island now. I think he has a land, probably. He's not trying to progress his board? We're going to attempt to play this. Yep, kind of figured that was going to happen. We're waiting to play around counter spells. For this Mole Drifter, we really want it resolved. We're kind of just waiting. Though the longer we wait, the less I feel confident. Ooh, that's pretty. Play that. The next turn, play around days while trying to draw a shitload of cards. He foils. Okay. Trying to make it so he can't cast Gurmag Anglers. As much as we keep his graveyard clear, the harder it makes him to cast Gurmag Anglers. Okay. Yeah, we're just keep on doing this stuff. Surprising he hasn't got any graveyard hate yet. Yeah. Dispel? Okay. Try casting the Mole Drifter now. Spell that. Exile card. Now we have Mortuary Mire for when the Mole Drifter dies. Okay, Gush. We know he has two islands in hand. He still has two islands in hand. Another Gurmag Angler, okay. Ooh, so we will go. Weight of Conscience. Oblivion Ring. And we'll wait. To play this Mortuary Mire. I have nothing for you to take, buddy. Play the island. Play Moldrifter. And we'll exile the Elver Seeker. Next turn we can bring that back. That is fine, sure. We go tap, 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 tap. Pass the Moldrifter. Play a Plains. Play a Lone Missionary. Back for 4. Last turn. That's fine. Okay, that's fine. Sure. Mortuary Mire, putting a Moldrifter on top. Yes, usability. Casting a Moldrifter. Draw a Moldrifter and something else. And Zorius Chancellor makes this so I can put more Moldrifter. Sounds good with me. Meantime, we'll gain some more life. We'll get rid of them, one of them. Alright, so we'll go play this, turn, Meyer. Ask Moldrifter. Swing for 4. Make him exile a card. Pass turn. Okay, another Gurmag Angler, which we already have like several answers to. And then we will go make this so it can't attack or block. Okay. O-ring. Target this. Mortuary Mire. Putting Mole Drifter on top. Wing. And Guardian of the Guild Pack. Heal through this turn. And we win. Okay, 2-2 going to match 3. I'll see you guys. 2-2 going to match 5. I'll see you guys there, right? Yes, I would like to play first. Okay, let's try to finish 3-2. Sure. Keep this hand. Play an island. Heal through this turn. Turn 1 Delver does not make me feel great. Play this. Return an island. Pass turn. Alright, well, no flip. Makes me feel better. Augur Bolas is good. Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Preordain. Alright, so draw, play. I think we go with... Oblivion Ring now on the Delver. Slow them down. Hope we draw another land. Squadron Hawk would be the worst draw at this point, but it is what it is. Felt like getting rid of the biggest threat would probably be the best choice. Take one, that's fine. And of course we draw a Squadron Hawk. Okay, well, make sure we don't draw another one. Yep. Okay. Okay, scred on that. I'm cool with that. Take one. Fine. Another auger. Okay. Okay. Well, we're gonna go Mortuary Mire. Set on top. And Squadron Hawk. Yes. Put that in my hand again. We're definitely blocking the spell spire spite if we get the chance. We do not though. Another planes? Nope. Squadron Hawk? Spell spire spite. Cool. This is starting to look bad. Needs more lands. We've drawn one black source. Our opening hand. Gone through 6 cards. Need a plains, to be honest. That is not a plains. Squadron Hawk again. Yep. We really need a planes. Basic land cycling, go get ourselves a planes, play the planes, play Squadron Hawk. Nope. Play Lone Missionary. Does have the counter spell for that. Technically, we're still alive, so we will wait one turn. For conceding and going on to game two. Block there. Okay. And we survive. Don't believe so. Yeah, okay, so concede game. Okay, so we definitely want dispels, right? And we want holy lights. I think that's it. And we want to take out. One angelic renewal. One Oblivion Ring, one Auromancer. One Aetherial Armor. Alright, like that. Moldrifter is just such a bomb if we can get resolved. Alright, yes, I would like to play first. And sure, I will keep. We're hoping to just draw land, just so we don't have to worry about it, but if we don't draw land, regardless, we're playing the Squadron Hawk. He chose to shuffle with his Ponder, by the way. Yes. Get all three of them. We'll, discard the Aetherial Armor right now. We want the least possible chance of drawing a non-land, so that's why we got all three. Normally I wouldn't, but I guess that is. And we still didn't get land. Squadron Hawk. Nope. Just exile this guy now. Hopefully we draw a land and can play Oromancer next turn. Don't really want to play any more Squadron Hawks into the possibility of Electricery. Hopefully we draw some lands starting next turn. 14 cards deep and drawn two lands. Stormbound, guys. That is kind of a bitch. There we go. That counts as two land drops pretty much. So we'll go tap. Tap. Squadron Hawk. Hopefully he doesn't have like trickery. If he does, whatever. Play the land. We were gonna have to discard that Squadron Hawk anyways, so makes no difference if it gets killed with like trickery. Or if it's discarded, either way it's in the graveyard. But if he doesn't have electricity, it makes our field a lot better presence. Okay. Play land. Then we will attempt to Oromancer. Counterspell happens. We'll Aether Armor one of these then. He's looking for a burn. Yep. No, we will not. Land. Poke this guy. Counterspell is probably what's gonna happen. Does not. Okay. Lands. There we go. And we will be using Angelic Removal. Alright, so we have 4 Skyfishers and a Helion Pilgrim for next turn. We're gonna cancel, we'll block with a Moldrifter. Ormancer. We will go get a conscience. Yes. Living Ring. Gosh. Counterspell. Okay. Rainstorm. Yeah, chump there. Take 2. Attempt to do that. Kind of figured that was happening. Or Skyfisher. Voice. Oh, cool. Or Skyfisher. Bringing back Ormancer. It sucks that we got stalled for on land so early in the game. Like, we wouldn't be in this situation. Like, we would have had a much better field presence and everything else like that. Like, kind of upset. Like, really upset. Block there, block one of these. Take 5. Yeah. Try playing the Pilgrims. Yes. Faith Fetter. Hope that he doesn't have a counter for this. Okay. No lightning bolt, no lightning bolt, no lightning bolt. Preordain. Top bottom. God damn it. Block here, block there. That's game. God damn it. All right. So, yeah, that. I mean, if let's be honest, the Boggles matchup was completely and utterly winnable. I just punted there. And then match five, I, two games in a row, I got screwed on lands. Like, that matchup is super winnable. And it's kind of disappointing that, like, we just got stuck on lands both games. Like, we got to hit our land drops against a grindy matchup like that. And it just didn't happen. And we almost turned the corner, like, both times, but it didn't work out. Other than that, like, the first matchup, I think it's possible to win against Monarch, but I don't think it's a great matchup. Though we did bleed blue-black Delver, and I feel like we beat it pretty handily. And then Burn, of course, we beat pretty handily. But blue-black Delver, considering it's such a big tier deck, and like it's played a lot, like I feel like this is encouraging. Only thing I am kind of worried about is we didn't face any Tron matchups, and if I remember from playing it before, I don't think Tron's a great matchup for this deck. Especially if Tron can get some sort of graveyard hate on against us, because they just, you know, they'd out like grind us pretty much. But other than that, pretty good league. It's just upsetting, you know, match five. Match three, that one I entirely take the blame for. I should have won that. I'll see you guys next video. Thanks.